Welcome to our final day in our reflections. And today we want to take this concluding day as a day of prayer. And as we have looked at several themes throughout our 21 days of prayer and fasting, we've looked at our theme, which says, no longer slaves. And we have taken steps to deepen our relationship with our God. We have taken time to reflect on our true identity as children of God. We have taken time to intercede for brothers and sisters. We have taken time to pray for our needs, the needs of the world. And today, as we conclude, I want us to look at the obstacles to our growth in spirit, our growth as Christians. What are some of the hindrances that can hinder us? And we are going to read from 2 Corinthians chapter 10, from verse 4. I'm reading from the Amplified Bible. It says, for the weapons of our warfare are not physical, weapons of flesh and blood, but they are mighty before God for the overthrow and destruction of strongholds. In as much as we refute arguments and theories and reasonings and every proud and lofty thing that sets itself up against the true knowledge of God, and we lead every thought and purpose away captive into the obedience of Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One, be in readiness to punish every insubordinate for his disobedience, when your own submission and obedience as a church are fully secured and complete. So, from here we have seen that the thoughts, you see, sometimes our thoughts hinders us to make a steadfast progress in our spiritual life. We make stunning blocks to ourselves. We limit ourselves. We limit what we can do. And this is what we are saying. Our weapons for warfare, because we live here on earth where there are two kingdoms, the kingdom of the devil and the kingdom of God. And now we are saying, for spiritual warfare, the weapons are not physical. They are not physical. We don't fight evil forces with the physical weapons. And some of the weaknesses is our thoughts. You see, we can see that there are things that are invisible. Thoughts are invisible. So there are spiritual attacks. The pattern that we think, when you steal something, it is visible. They can be seen, the evidence can be brought. But now, if you sin in your thoughts, there is no evidence. That is a spiritual sin. So now, when St. Paul is telling us, we refute arguments. The arguments that people argue about, all kinds of philosophies, that will not bring salvation and hope to your health, to your Christian life. Every knowledge that raises against the true knowledge of God. Now, we have become the light to the world. We've become the light to the nation. So, when we pray, our faith assures of things unseen. But again, the limitation may be our way of thinking. We begin to reason our way out, asking God to do something for you, and you begin to think otherwise. Maybe God is not willing to do this for me. Maybe God will start limiting God. These are the thoughts that we're supposed to take captive of. Do not water the weeds in your field. The weeds are this kind of thoughts, this kind of double standard living. Well, Jesus has given us the assurance. Anything apart from yes or no are from the devil. No blue lies, no white lies. Say the truth. So, we may put limitation on God, thinking, God, there is something he cannot do. And we limit ourselves. When you see people asking God to help them, they limit him. They ask for 2,000 to 10,000. They can't ask for 1 million because that would be too much. So they have made already a block to their progress. No, cancer cannot be healed, so this is my fate. They make a block to their healing because that's what the world says. So today, as we're going to pray, Father God and in heaven, we thank you today. We rebuke every thought that rises against the standard you have set for us as children of God. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke and believe in every person who is listening to this. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my Father and God, you have said you have given us the spirit of adoption that cries out, Abba, Father. You have not given us the spirit of timidity and fear. We rebuke that fear to evangelize in the name of Jesus Christ, my Father and my God. We rebuke that disobedience to faith in the name of Jesus Christ. We raise a standard against the enemy in the homes where the enemies take foot. We rebuke him in the name of Jesus. The enemy is taking hold of marriages of our brothers and sisters. We rebuke him. We rebuke him and restore that peace in that marriage in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. My Father and my God, we restore peace. We restore healing in that body. We rebuke and unbelief those sins of the spirit. We pray in the name of Jesus and we rebuke them by the power of the Holy Spirit. My Father and my God, you have said whatsoever shall bind on earth remain bound in heaven. We bind them. We bind them in the name of Jesus Christ. We lay the standard against them. We pray, my Father and my God, as you have channeled together, as you are journeying together in faith, let the peace of Christ come upon every person hearing this in the name of Jesus. Bless the work of their hands. Bless everything they do, everything concerning them in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. My Father and my God, we rebuke the spirit of failure in the name of Jesus. My Father and my God, you have told us we are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. Every spirit of failure, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Whatever the enemy has said about us, every spirit that raise against the children of God, will rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Every curtation and spell from the pit of hell in the mighty name of Jesus will rebuke you and destroy you in the name of Jesus Christ. My Father and my God, any family that is experiencing disturbance in their marriages, will rebuke that spirit of divorce. Will rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Will rebuke you and bind you and cast you with the cross of Jesus. My Father and my God, any child, any spirit of disobedience in our children, will rebuke them in the name of Jesus. You said, my Father and my God, you bless the work of our hands. Bless our businesses. Bless our academics. Bless our businesses. Bless everything that we do to the glory of your name. My Father and my God, I rebuke every sickness right now. Every sickness in the people listening to my voice right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We rebuke you, we cast you out. We claim the abundance of life Jesus gave us on the cross. May the blood of Jesus Christ wash us. May the Holy Spirit heal us totally. Restore peace in marriage. Restore peace in marriage. Restore peace in marriage. In the mighty name of Jesus, give the partners the peace and trust they need. We rebuke any spirit that is dividing the families. We rebuke you and destroy you in the name of Jesus. You have no place in our families in the name of Jesus. Every spell of failure, every spell of sickness, will rebuke you and destroy you. The power and the name of Jesus, bow down to the name of Jesus. will set peace, our houses on peace, with the love of God, the peace of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, my Father. Every stronghold, we rebuke them, we destroy them, every stronghold in our families, we destroy them. Every influence of witchcraft and satanism, we rebuke them and destroy their foundation, in the name of Jesus, my Father and my God. For your greater glory, we shall prosper, we shall glorify your name, in Jesus' mighty name. Remember, you are loved, and God loves you. Shalom, shalom. It is well. Amen.